Dear Diane, hello. This is a letter. Rehab is making me write a letter to a friend because I guess letter writing is therapeutic. I hear it did wonders for the Zodiac Killer. Anyway, rehab's going fine. A lot of hikes and movie nights and yoga. And I think next week we're doing a color war. And it's good that I'm here. And it's good that I'm not drinking or taking pills, but I keep thinking about how this isn't real life. It's summer camp. Temporary. Easy. As nice as this is, I know that someday I'll have to go back to the real world.
Hey, lady, listen, can you put him on the phone, please? I don't care if he doesn't want to talk to me. I'm his father. No, lady.
Anyway, that's my letter. I probably won't even send it, but if you're reading this, I guess I did. Your friend, BoJack. P.S. Horseman. Dear Diane, hello. I am writing you another letter. Today sucks. There's this new lady here, Beverly, and she took my snack kit. And that is so classic Beverly. Probably. I just met her. The whole point of the snack kits is they're communal, right? They're these bags full of snacks that we take on our morning hikes and we put them together the night before as like a team building thing. Yesterday, I decided to throw an extra bag of candied nuts into a snack kit, something just for me. And I marked my bag with a B so I'd know which one to grab in the morning. B for BoJack. But then today, I see Beverly, who, again, just got here, waltzing around the house with my snack kit, saying, "Ooh, somebody made a special kit just for me. B for Beverly. I must have a secret admirer." Again, just got here. The story of my life is that I never get anything nice. You'd think that I'd learn to adjust my expectations by now, but no. Once again, I was the idiot who got my hopes up about candied nuts, and now I am disappointed with no one to blame but myself. Anyway, what's new with you? Just kidding, you can't say anything, this is a letter. Okay, talk soon. BoJack. It was Beverly's last day yesterday. Everyone is real excited for her, but she spent the whole day sulking because she never found out who her secret admirer was. Frankly, it was getting pretty annoying, so finally I just say, "It was me. I'm in love with you." And she goes, "Oh, I was hoping it was Mario." And then she starts crying. And everyone looks at me like, "Way to go, you made Beverly cry on her last day." So the thing I keep thinking about is, was it worth it for Beverly to be happy for a little bit, even though it ended up sad? Or would it have been better if the whole thing never happened? Every time someone leaves rehab, it makes you think about your own progress. Some days it feels like you're not progressing at all. Other days you think, well, maybe a little. The main thing I think about is how stupid I am that I didn't do this sooner. I wasted so many years being miserable because I assumed that was the only way to be. And I don't want to do that anymore. Also, am I crazy? Or have I gotten really good at writing letters? This is BoJack, by the way.
Dear Diane, it's me, your old pen pal Leo. This definitely isn't BoJack Horseman writing this. You're a good person, Diane, and that's the most important thing. Even if no one appreciates you, it's important that you don't stop being good. I like how you always bring your own bags to the grocery store and how you're always organized to go places. I like how you chew gum on the airplane so your ears will pop. A lot of people might not appreciate that about you, but I do. Yours forever. Thank you.